In this video, we're going to talk about a geometric series and the convergence test for geometric series. I also have another video that will talk about the sum of a geometric series, but I'll do that in another video. A geometric series is one that has a common ratio or multiplier that's not equal to zero. So for example, this first question, the first sequence, or if I plugged in zero, if I just list a couple terms here, I'd have 2 times 3 to the 0, which is 2. The next would be when n equals 1, so 2 times 3 to the 1st, which is 6. Then 2 times 3 squared, so 2 times 18, excuse me, 2 times 9, which is 18. And then if I plugged in 3, 2 times 3 cubed, or 2 times 27 would be 54. So what's happening here is that I'm multiplying by 3 every time to get to the next step. So the common ratio or multiplier is 3. Okay. Now, I didn't really need to list terms, but because of course you can see that, 3 is the thing being raised to the n power. This is what I'm going to be multiplying by every time. But I thought it might be kind of useful to do that the first time. This next one, easy to pick out, right? It's just going to be 5/4. It's the thing being raised to the n each time. Over here, it might be useful to think instead of 4 over 3 to the n, really it's 4 multiplied by 1 over 3 to the n, which is the same as 4 multiplied by 1/3 to the n. And then you can right away see that, their common ratio is 1/3. This one, the common ratio, remember it's just whatever's being raised the power, so it's negative 1/3. It can be negative, that's okay. This just means that the series will alternate, meaning the one term will be positive, the next term will be negative, next term will be positive, and so on. But you're still multiplying by something every time, negative 1/3. This next one, again, you look at this negative exponent, I might think about rewriting this. I'd say, well, instead of pi to the negative n, why don't I write that as 1 over pi to the n, which is the same as 1 over pi all to the n. So then the common ratio is 1 over pi. Okay. This one, this last one, I might think about rewriting this as 2 multiplied by 2 to the n. Okay. Now just make sure you see 2 multiplied by 2 to the n is 2 to the n plus 1, right? Because when we are multiplying exponents, we add their exponents. Or when we're multiplying exponential functions, we add the exponents when the bases are the same. So 2 times 2 to the n is like 2 to the first times 2 to the n. Well, then I could rewrite this because both the 2 to the n and 5 to the n, they have the same exponent. I could rewrite this as 2 multiplied by 2 over 5 to the nth power. So I think now, written in this way, it's pretty easy to pick out that the common ratio is 2/5. So for a geometric series, what we're looking for is that some number, I'm going to put a number here, is being raised to the nth power. I'll put the little sum sigma out there in front, but that's what we're looking for. Now, it could be multiplied by another number like this. It could be multiplied by 2 or 6. We might have to do a little algebra to get it in the form we like. 4 divided by 3 to the n, we rewrote it. Pi to the negative n, we rewrote it. But that's what we're looking for. That's what makes something geometric. It's a number raised to the nth power. So then the question is, how do we know if the geometric series converges? Well, this is the convergence test for a geometric series. So if the number inside the box, that ratio, is between negative 1 and 1, the series converges. The series diverges if the number isn't between negative 1 and 1. So it really, the number, what's inside that box, has to be with that. Can't be equal to 1. It has to be less than positive 1, but greater than negative 1. So here we found the common ratio was 3. So this obviously diverges. The common ratio is too big. Here, the common ratio was 5/4. Remember, the common ratio is whatever's being raised to the nth power. So this also diverges. In this example, in the previous slide, we'd rewritten. So if you recall, it was 4 multiplied by 1/3 to the n. Okay. Well, now the common ratio is 1/3. We can see that with this rewrite, this converges. Okay, so again, you might have to do some rewriting to see it, but we're looking for this form where it's a number raised to the nth power. We could have a constant multiplier. We could have to maybe yank a constant down or something, but that's what we're looking for. So here, negative 1/3 raised to the n, well, it's negative, but yeah, it's between negative 1 and 1, so this converges. If you recall, this we rewrote as 1 over pi to the nth power. Well, 1 over pi, of course, is 1 over 3.14159, on. That's definitely less than 1, so this converges. And this, if you remember, we rewrote as 2 multiplied by 2/5 to the n, common ratio of 2/5, so this converges as well. The geometric series is a pretty special one for us because not only is it one that we can identify pretty easily, we're looking for a number raised to the nth power, a number raised to the nth power. But it's also one of the very few series that easily we can not only tell if it converges or diverges, but tell if it converges, what it converges to. Meaning, what's the sum of the infinite series? And I'm going to, in another video, show you a very quick proof of that and a couple examples of how we can find that sum. But make sure you understand the geometric series. It is a pretty easy series and a pretty basic one, and one that'll definitely get, you know, some very quick work if you can spot it quickly, that it's just a number raised to the nth power. Don't pay attention, really, to the constants, or if you had to do a little algebra to get it to the right form.